perfection. Perfection, though, is a rare commodity. But in Montreal in 1976, a 14-year-old Romanian gymnast attracts the eyes of the world. Her name is Nadia Comăneci, and this tiny teenager achieves something no one has done before. She's awarded the first perfect 10 in Olympic history, and then six more. Nadia Comăneci becomes the darling of the Montreal Olympics, the schoolgirl who achieved perfection.
Nadia Comăneci, just 14 when she scored the first perfect 10. Many of the gymnasts who'll compete in Sydney are just school children, regular kids making huge sacrifices to mix training for the Olympics with the regular routine of school days.
It's just as well the Sydney Olympic Games will be held during the school holidays. Otherwise, Trudy McIntosh's diary would read, Monday, English and Maths. Tuesday, Olympic Gymnastics. 15-year-old Trudy and her best mate Melinda Cleland share a passion for producing the perfect 10, whether it's in the classroom, the gym, or in the kitchen.
Welcome to Trudy and Melinda's kitchen, and today we're going to make for you, what do you reckon, Min?
Some pear and cinnamon low-fat muffins.
Sounds pretty good. I'll chop up the pears and you can...
Right. Well, no one can say that food is their consuming passion.
Let's go, girls.
Trudy and Melinda are more like sisters than competitors, even though they're both fighting for a spot in Australia's Olympic gymnastics team.
We don't fight very often, believe it or not. Yeah, we're like best mates. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Do everything together.
Yeah, we don't seem to like have big screaming fights where the doors are slamming or anything like that. We just, I don't know, have a little bicker, I suppose. That's about it.
That's the recipe for these Olympic hopefuls. Domestic bliss and definitely a low-fat diet.
Beautiful, Min. Another triumph.
They're pretty good.
Sensational.
That's exactly how the gymnastics world describes McIntosh. Nicknamed the Pocket Rocket, the pint-sized pixie is packed with enough fast-twitch fibres to make Matt Shervington envious. These fibres enable her to perform manoeuvres that are definitely not for the faint-hearted.
Well, this is the moment we've been waiting for on the women's vault. Trudy McIntosh,
starting with her signature vault.
The McIntosh has taken 5 years to develop, and Trudy is the only one in the world who's done it. Thankfully, the tongue-twisting, full-twisting front layout is now simply referred to as the McIntosh. Named after its creator, it's a lot tougher than Year 10 algebra. To get this far has been a huge sacrifice for Trudy and her family. She was just 7 when she and her mum moved to Melbourne, 8 years ago. The rest of the family stay at home in Geelong, an hour's drive away. Her coach reckons the sacrifice is worth it.
So many 15-year-olds get a shot at going to Olympics, and both those two particularly probably been around the world 4 or 5 times at that age. So while there's some things that you might say as a normal 15-year-old they don't do, there's a lot of things that they do which, you know, a bunch of other 15-year-olds would never have an opportunity to do.
At the World Championships last year, our girls produced their best ever effort, finishing one spot above the Atlanta gold medalist, the USA. Trudy finished 5th on the vault, the best ever result by an Aussie gymnast. Now, Trudy has a new routine designed specially for the Sydney Olympics. After hour upon hour in the gym, it is finally unveiled at the Australian Championships. It's designed to tug the national heartstrings. Maybe even produce our first ever gymnastics medal.
Yay, Trudy! Well, it was a great routine. Is it going to be good enough?
What's the show?